What's up, people? This is Brandon here. Today we're going to be setting up the Moog Sub 37 for use in Logic Pro X. First thing you need to do if you haven't already is register your Sub 37 at moogmusic.com, and then you can gain access to the editor software. After installing that, open the Sub 37 editor and update the firmware, also if you haven't done that already. And if you're now at a point where you have the editor open and standalone, go ahead and close out of it, and we are going to start fresh. Let's open Logic Pro X and start with a new project so that you understand how it works, and then you can go back and add it to a project that you're already working on. When prompted to choose a track type, choose External MIDI. Use External Instrument Plugin. Select your MIDI destination. By the way, we are plugging in by USB, so this is a direct connection to my computer. You're going to select Moog Sub 37. I'm going to do Channel 1. And choose your audio input. For me, that is input 10. This is the channel that you have your Sub 37 plugged into your system. And I'm going to keep my audio output the same. One track and create. We can go ahead and close out of this window. Let's check and make sure we have a sound. All right. With that track selected, go to Audio Effects, Audio Units, Moog Music, Sub 37 Editor, and Mono. The editor will open up on its own and show the current patch loaded on the Sub 37. From here, you can record. Edit. And play that audio back on your Sub 37. One of the coolest features about using the editor in Logic is that it saves the patch that you used in that project. So if you completely close down this project and use your Sub 37 on something else, when you come back to this, it's going to open up whatever patch you had saved last. Don't forget, since this is an external instrument, you cannot simply bounce in place to save your audio. You're going to have to record your audio directly to another track or use another bounce method. And that's that on setting up your Moog Sub 37 for use in Logic Pro X.